Well, good evening and welcome to Liberty Stadium, where Swansea City's under-23s have the chance to finish the 2017-18 campaign with back-to-back Premier League Cup titles. No side has yet done that in development football history. Tonight, promotion-chasing Aston Villa stand in the Swans' way of that, following their playoff win over Reading on Tuesday. Tonight's team, Swansea City's under-23s, name an unchanged starting 11 from the side that beat Sheffield United 3-0 in the semi-final last Friday.
Forward now with Callum O'Hare. Now with Corey Blackett-Taylor on the overlap. Crosses in, almost found the back of the net. That came deflected off of Ben Cabango. Just missing a bit of quality, and Kenji Gore does get through it. It could be 1-0, but it's good tackle by Isaiah Beasley-Graham. Now Swansea coming again. Gore to Byers to Adnan Maric, through to Daniel James with a shot. Blocked again, this time by Mitchell Clark. Jack Clark now at Blackett-Taylor into the area. Hepburn-Murphy doesn't get hold of it properly, but does so now. He's got Ben Cabango for company. Aaron Lewis with a shot, but just around the post there. Hepburn-Murphy plays Suter O'Hare and gets the shot away, but another great save by Steve Bender. Ball for Gore from Daniel James. Gore continues to come forward. Baker Richardson's there, but well saved by Sarkic. Down low to deny the striker. And then Maric now back on the ball and fighting. Corny Baker Richardson's there, but got a bit of a connection, but that's going to be going out for a goal kick. Byers ball now, releases Daniel James, goes on the break again. Corny Baker Richardson's in the area. Daniel James, though, on the ball to Kenji Gore. Now to Byers. Adnan Maric. Adnan Maric on his left foot. Machine Hepburn-Murphy dropping deep. Coming forward though. The number nine, the striker, driving into the area. Is this going to be a goal? Just wide by Jordan Cox. Aaron Lewis. And that is the final whistle. Wraps up normal time. We are heading to extra time. Still goalless. George Byers runs onto that one, and is there going to be a break now for Swansea? Plays in Daniel James. Daniel James racing into the area. Blocked by Sarkic. Into the area again. Ben Cabango. Hepburn-Murphy on the edge of the area. Shot a goal. Oh, and that was so close. Matthew Blake had the header. And that is the full-time whistle. Stay with us. We're live from Liberty Stadium tonight. Penalty kicks will decide this season's Premier League Cup final. Matija Sarkic makes himself big in the goal. Byers kick. And it's saved by Sarkic. Kelsey Mooney. This time Bender makes himself big. Is there going to be more heroics from the German tonight? Almost to it. Great spot kick, right into the corner, wrong-sided, Sarkic. It's 2-1. Hepburn-Murphy, the striker who couldn't find the back of the net tonight. Is he going to find it now? Does so. Rolls it into the corner. Bender went the other way. 3-1, Villa. Scored against Brighton in the quarter-finals. And it's saved again. Matic Sarkic, and that really does put Aston Villa in the driving seat to win the Premier League Cup tonight. Disappointment, unless Swansea have something more with Steve Bender. It's right into the corner. Villa win the Premier League Cup in 2018. No dream ending to the season for Swansea. They fought hard the entire campaign, the entire match. But it's Aston Villa who lift the title, who spoil the party.
Yeah, obviously the boys' heads are down at this particular moment in the changing room now, but you know, I think for the neutrals, probably a good game to watch, certainly non a nil-niller. And yeah, we think we had a couple of chances to win it, but being fair to them, so did they.
Even at the end when we lost, they were still there supporting. You could hear the groans and the whinges when we were missing chances, and the relief when they missed a couple. But it did really help, and I hope at the end we showed our appreciation in the right way.
Yeah, I think when the pain of this defeat goes, I think we'll sit down and look back at the season and be very pleased with it. I think we've got better as the season's gone on, and as well as that, you know, a lot of changes in the team and young players have come through and played particularly well.
I'll back all them boys in there, and I think we've had a great season, in all fairness.